Well, g'day, Tubes. How's she going? Well, got some more snow last night. Not much, just a little bit of powdery crap. I might as well just take the plow out on the three-point hitch there and plow off the bits. So, looks like we got a little bit of rusty last night. Not bad. Not bad. Now, that's not showing the other side yet, but... see anything there or not, I can't, but anyways, I guess we're going to do some more welding. I want to do some more stitching on the doobies. I think that should help stiffen them to get those plates together, and I know I was almost out of gas yesterday. Don't got very much today either. Didn't fill itself up overnight. Oh darn. So I guess we can only go as far as we can. And we'll have to grab another tank, but knowing this TSC here, they probably don't have one, so I think they get their trucks in or whatever the whatchamacallem guys here, what the heck's their names? I don't know, the gas guys. They come in, I think every Thursday afternoonish or something, but who knows, they might have one, they might not have one, they never really seem to until the Thursday, but I think they only get maybe two in anyways, but I don't know. But anyways, we'll get as far as we can, and should have a looky see too. How much? A bit of wire there. I don't know how much though, but look like a whole lot. But I think I got another roll in there anyhow. So, and actually, I've got some. I think these were them. Those are 30s. I think these ones here, maybe. Yeah, I've got some 35 thou tips here because I know I've got a partial roll of wire of 35 thou I should burn up maybe up in here. Should probably be using the rest of this up. Still a fair bit on there yet, so that I do believe was the 35 thou, yeah. So I should probably be using that up, I guess. And that'll help thicken her up a bit faster too. But anyways, we'll go out here and fire up the tractor and pick up my gloves. I got her inside, but it won't go in with the front dewy on either, so I have to take it off and to put it in. But anyways, let's crack the door open first. And get this a bit more light and some focus. And well, wrong side. And we'll get this thing fired up. Just gonna check the oil first. It should be okay, but it's actually getting higher for some reason, but it's staying fairly clean, eh? From that last change we did. And it's got almost 25 hours on it since the last change, and it's staying pretty clean, so. Oh, neutral. There we go. Okay, ready? There we go. Oh, we'll let her warm up. And we'll go put our snow pants on. Alright, so we got the snow done, and I got a call for a funeral coming in. Can't film that. Sorry. Private. But anyways, I got my want to hook the blower back up, but she's all frozen on the dewy there, so we got her just piping in some nice exhaust heat there and melting off the little shaft dewy there so I can get her slipped back onto the tractor. So let's have a look. Oh, it's not gonna do much down there. Yeah, that'll heat her up. Working though, eh? Pretty redneck, but it works. Anyways, I gotta go clear a couple of few spots out back there, and I might be able to even try out the new ripper tooth here. I don't know how much frost is in the ground back there, but we might have to hook her up. But fortunately, I won't be able to show you that because I'm not going to be filming back there too much anymore. So I haven't heard anything so about it. But anyways, enough of that said. So yeah, I'm gonna get that blower on there, and I'll probably even cut back a few more snowbanks while I was out there too. So, but anyways, I'm gonna get back to some welding soon. Hopefully, holy, it's almost lunchtime. Alrighty, so I guess we're good to go. Get some more lines drawn on the back of this plow. That should help stiffen her up a bit. Shouldn't be able to flex itself as much, you know. So, because basically, you know, there's nothing between these ribs tying them things all together yet. So, thinking once we get that joined together, and glued together, she should be good. So, I'm almost out of gas. So, like I was saying earlier, but we'll get as far as we can, I guess, and shouldn't really take too long to do this because it's just kind of like a done, you know. It's not very thick, so could speed along pretty good with it. So, but anyways, let's get some welding going, and I'll show you maybe doing a couple of these lines, and then I'll just do the rest up, and then probably show you when we're all done. Okay, so on this welder, I got the auto set feature thing. I don't generally use it too much. I kind of like to fine-tune the heat settings and the speed settings for the wire myself. So I'm gonna try her here, and I got her fairly fast wire speed, but you just basically, let's show you here, you put her on the auto set here with like thickness ranges. So that one and this one. So I'm gonna just try the first one. There's the two there, and then maybe about an 8 wire speed or something. I don't know, somewhere in around there. Might be a bit too fast, but we'll try her and see. So it's supposed to be able to set its own, once it detects the metal, I guess, it sets its own speed for the heat and stuff, right? So I'm gonna start probably finishing the bottom two down there on the right side of your screen, and see how we can do here. I want to adjust my mask a bit to lighten it up a little bit, maybe. As long as I can get her, I guess. It's hard to sometimes see the welds that you're going long, right? So, let's go. That's a bit too fast. Down to 6 maybe. I'm having trouble seeing the line, it's so small, right? But,
I keep going here.
I'm gonna try setting it myself, or maybe I'll try the other setting. There, I'll go a little bit hotter with it. Too bad, but leaving it pretty raised. So I'm gonna go and try to set it myself now. Right in and around there. Do this next line here. I can see it. Bad, but it's a little bit of a gap there, so I'm gonna do a little more speedish, wire speedish, and let's try this again. There, I think we nailed her now. Well, there's the auto set stuff. It's all right. I'm not crazy about it, but then this is where I set it. A little bit more better looking. So anyways, I don't know. Auto set's fine, but it might be good for if you're beginning or something, but once you get a little more experience under your belt, you probably want to, you know, play with it a bit more and put your own settings on. So, but anyways, I'm going to get going here, I guess. Going as long as I can until the gas is probably out, and hopefully we get her done. Well, we didn't get along too far, and she timed out on us. But anyways, we'll keep going when she's cooled off again, but we are just about out of gas. There is almost resting on the needle thing there, so, or the pin, so yeah, maybe I might get the rest of this finished and start another one. That'll probably be it. Actually, I noticed it sort of started to get a little bit blurbly there, so it's probably running low now, but anyways. I thought I didn't do any damage to this thing yesterday, but have a look at this. In here, we must have pushed this one plate a little bit. See her there, and then I didn't think I was pushing on anything that hard, but I'm going to show you this. You can see the gappage here. She's pushed up a bit, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to get that back in, but I'll have to trust my trusty, maybe this thing or something. That might squish her back in for us. Of course, I'm going to need two hands, so one sec. Okay, I think that's got her a little better. I kind of pushed her a bit too much in the front, but that's all right. And I guess I'll have to somehow try to get in there to weld that seam, because I'm going to want that fairly solid by the looks of things. I can get some here and then maybe a bit through that little hole and then a little bit there. Maybe have to go underneath and try to that way, you know, but we'll get her. She's going to need some reinforcing though there, I guess, by the looks of things. So I don't remember hitting anything really hard, but maybe it was just that heavier snow. I wouldn't think that would do that, but that's why I wanted to kind of weld them all together, you know, so they should be all solid now. So instead of pushing just on the one, it's going to have to push on all 50 of those there, you know, so she should be good. But anyways, we're still flinking here. And when she's ready, we'll rock on. And looks like I'm going to need to get gas. I should probably call out there and see if they got one. Maybe I'll do that. Okay, so I give them a call there, TSC, and they got four in stock. Awesome. So we'll burn up the rest of this tank here, and then we'll probably head her out and grab a NAR one and bring her back, hook her up, and hopefully she's full. Because I've had an issue once. If you remember back there when I went to, they didn't have any in Orangeley, so I went up to Allison just across from the John Deere dealer there and got one, brought it back, and I guess this lady was new or something. She gave me an empty one. Wasn't too happy. That's like an hour's drive each way. But anyways, let's keep on welding. We're cooled off here, and we'll see how much further we can get on this tank. Holy jump, if it's not one thing, it's freaking 10. Yep, we're out. But anyways, I guess we'll switch to a new thing of wire. Should have all my stuff here. I need to do that. Get a pair of cutters and something else I'm gonna need too. I guess I might switch to that 35 thou. We'll burn the rest of that up. Well, I guess I'll give you a crash course how to change this. And what you gotta do is, hopefully my tip's cooled off a bit. Not enough. gotta get a pair of gloves here. Gotta pull your tip off. That's cool. And basically what you gotta do is pull, like you got her on loose here, I chopped that little end off. Gotta pull the left out of this, what's left in the line, so that's kind of waste, but that's the way she's done. So, and then we're gonna put a 35 thou wire in, so we gotta change our tip here too. This is the contact tip. That just screws into the Dewey there, so that tip's still good. So we'll save that one, we'll find our 35s. And cut through this crap. We'll get one of these out. One of them out, and put this back in the gun. Sounds okay. So we'll thread this back in. That's good. And you can put your tip back on if she's cooled enough. That one's not bad. Okay, keep your gun kind of handy because you're going to need her in a sec. Okay, now let's get you a bit closer here. Okay, so now where's the end? I think that's it there. So put your, it's got a little hole there, so this thing's got to go in the Dewey there. And you can tighten this thing back on. Find the end. Now don't let it go. I've done her before and it just whoosh. And you gotta feed her into this plastic feeder thing here. And this goes up over your drive wheel. But now I've gotta check and make sure that I've got the right. Yeah, I think that should work. 30, yeah, that's 24 thou. So where we were was fine. I think, yeah. And there, okay. And just feed her up over the drive wheel there, and then try to feed her into this, into your liner, they call that. Get her in there, push your tension Dewey down, and tighten her back on. That's just like a quick thing, eh? You tighten her actually with that up and down, whatever. So now, grab your Dewey and give her some throttle. That's feeding her all through the gun and everything again. Gotta clean some junk out of there, I see. There we go, it's not too bad. So feed her through, feed her through, feed her through until she comes out. You can actually feel it's about here, up, and out she comes. You actually feel it going through the gun, it's pretty cool. And that's it. We've got some 35 now, so probably going to need a little bit more heat. And we'll get back to the project for about 2 minutes probably until the bottle's right empty here, which it's pretty much done. So anyways, let's see what we can do here. Wowee, that 35 thou must draw a bit more juice to put her down because I didn't get very far. I got, we didn't do very much at all, really. We got the rest of that one finished. And we did that one, and then just to there, and then that was it. So, holy, I might switch that back out. I'm not super crazy on that. I like to go for a little while, holy, but anyways, I got the tank off. I'm going to take her back while this is cooling off here, and then we'll get an exchanged one and come back and finish this. So, holy. But I got to make sure I got another 30 thou, or I might have to grab one when I'm out there. I do. 30 thou box still. Okay. But you know, if they have one on them out there, it might not be a bad idea to just grab another one of these. So maybe that's what I'll do. But yeah, that 30 thou is better than 5 thou of an inch isn't that much. But man, that really chilled out fast or heated her up fast. So, but anyways, let's head her out to TSE and probably won't take you out there. He's been out there lots. And we'll get another tank, come back, and get this finished up for today. Well, we got back with a nice new bottle of frickin' stuff here, and hopefully when we turn her on, she goes up to where that black tick is on the Dewey here. Hopefully it doesn't stay where it is. Wow. I got kind of gypped, I think, on that one. That's not too good. Oh well, what do you do? I guess they didn't fill her up to where she's supposed to be, but supposed to be up to that black tick, so I'm actually down about 300 pounds. Frig's eggs. Oh well. Hey, I'll use her, I guess, but I'm not going out just to exchange it for that, so. But anyways, I got another roll of wire, and they had this Lincoln Electric stuff here for, you know, the other welder, but this is a better welder. But anyways, I only got it because where the heck's the Dewey's? The ones I was getting, like these ones, are a 10-pound spool. Alright, and this is a 12.5-pound spool. So you get a little bit more, another 2.5 pounds of wire on there, so that's alright, but I think I'm going to yank this back out of here. Maybe, maybe not. But anyways, I'm going to have to probably pop the thing off the end there and cut the wire again, so one sec, I'll yank her back through here. Alrighty, so that roll is like full. Like it was so full it was actually like spilling off the edges. I'm trying to feed it here. So anyways, we got her going. Should pop out here in a second. There she goes. And it's a 35 thou tip there, so I'm going to switch it back to the 30, I think. And we should be good to keep going here. Well, I guess that's going to be it for today. I got her all finished there and then started putting a couple more layers just on the mount there. And then, you know, she timed out on me. So that's probably going to be it for today for welding. But we got her all stitched as best as I could underneath, too. There's a little small area just underneath this plate here that I couldn't reach accurately enough to get a good weld. So, but we got most of her. I think she should be good. She's all done there, all done there. I haven't missed any, I don't think, so that's good. So that should stiffen her up a bit, and should add a bit more weight to her too, so she'll have a good scrape down now, holy. But, yeah, I'm going to just let that cool and call her a day on the welding, I guess, because I used that tank there, and I was bent over that all day, you know, and right on my gut there, and it kind of hurt when I got up, you know, like, pain-wise, for a sharp pain for a couple of seconds, so... I think it was just the weight of me pushing down on me kind of thing, you know, and holding that position for doing that. So should have her up on a table, but geez, I'd never get her off. But anyways, I guess that should do her. And we've got some paint. I picked up some John Deere yellow paint while I was out at TSC there. So... might go over these with the grinder maybe just to smooth them off a little nicer looking and get her a bit nicer for the paint job. So, but anyways, I guess that's gonna be her for today. I got tractor to put away and I left that other one out there for last night and probably tonight while this is in here kind of thing. So but anyways, yeah, she's looking good, and hopefully she's good and strong now, and might even put some cross pieces. I don't know. I think it's going to probably be strong enough now as it is, and hopefully she don't bend, because if she does, that'll be the end of her. She'll be junk. So I don't know if I'd ever get her bent straight again. So I imagine that cutting edge there would hold her fairly straight, but interestingly how that one inside there we kind of pushed out a bit. But she should be good now. She's all solid. And I'm not going to weld it on the other side. I'm just going to do the one side. Probably wouldn't hurt doing the other side, but nah, I think that'll be a lot strong enough there. So now I might add some side pieces, maybe, like, I don't know. Might not be a bad idea, you know. Maybe put a piece from here to here, and then from here to here, kind of thing. And I think that'll help if it happens to wanna, when you're plowing, push that side really hard or something. It's gonna have to push the whole entire thing to bend her now, instead of just like this edge kind of thing, right? So maybe tomorrow or something, I'll get some 12-inch pieces cut. I know there's one there that could go in. It's 12, 12, 12, 12 all the way across. So that's probably what I'll do, is run beams this way and then that way. I think that should be a lot strong enough. So, but tomorrow, not today. I'm not going to get into that today. So anyways, I got the gas shut off. I just got to let that cool down a bit, and head her up and do a kinder egg, I guess. So just before we go up, that's interesting to see how much wire I fired on that thing. That was up over the, well, not over the top of those edges, but right darn pretty much even, I would say. Like, it was enough that a couple of little loops fell off on me, you know. So let's put a fair bit of wire on there, you know. That's pretty good. So I know that she's in there and good and solid and stuff, so should be awesome. Well, I don't imagine there's going to be a huge long video today, but let's add a bit to her. Maybe we'll do a grimy cold start here on the 110. She's been sitting out 2 days, I guess, now. Just like it was never even shut off. That's weird. I don't know why I was having so much trouble before with it. Fired right up that time. Well, I like it when it does that. That's how it's supposed to do it. I don't know, that's weird why I was having that trouble before. Maybe something was draining the battery down or something stupid. Who knows, eh? But anyways. Oh no, she's not seizured. I felt like it was a bit frozen. It's okay. But anyways, I know some of you were asking for a grimy start on that thing. Which, my key. We can try if I can even get the door open. As I bet you she's maybe frozen. Close. Oh no, we're good. Alrighty. Oh, look at the water sitting down in there. No wonder the floor's rot out, eh? Holy frig. I don't know where it's coming in, but it could be up through the window there. I don't know. Okay. I don't know if the battery's up on this thing or not. Never seem to have an issue with the battery in this one, but get a bit of fuel pumped up to the curb. There's some foot pedaling. Oh boy. I don't know, boys. Oh, little burpler. She'll go now, watch. Hey! Rely on your Jeep product, eh? Pretty good for an old carbonated piece of junk. Now, I won't be able to drive her today because the flat tire on the front, we gotta fix that sometime, and I can't even see my my freaking windshield here, so. Well, we, no wonder these floors rot out the way. There's like an inch of ice down there. Holy frig. Man. I think maybe you're better just to cut that out of there. Put a piece of steel wiry mesh down in there, like the expanded mesh stuff, you know, and all that crap. We just go through it. What a freaking nightmare. Oh well. But I imagine he's probably leaking up around the windshield or something stupid. You never know. It looks like it's right there, actually. I can see back in there, I can see a bit of ice. Looks like it's coming in around that windshield, so. But she seemed to start. We'll let her run for a minute, maybe, and warm it up and stuff, and juice up the battery again. She's getting a bit of a shock there, it looks like, so it's good. Lots of oil pressure when she's cold, because it's like blue. And I've got just under half a tank of fuel, and she's cold. So, yeah, it's not too bad, but. Might as well go shut the tractor off. I guess it doesn't need to be running. Well, she's been running, I don't know, 10 minutes or so. Seems to be running on fast idle pretty good there. It's probably around 2,000 RPM or something. So let's get in here and see how much heat we got. She's almost 2,000 there. She's warming up pretty good. That's good. Firing a bit of heat up here. That's good. Anyways, I guess we'll tap her down a bit. Just over 1,000 here now. And seem to be running pretty good. Got a pretty low oil pressure though, really, now that it's warmed up a wee bit. It's better than zero, I guess. Going in it or something. Could be, who knows. The whole motor's getting tired really, but anyway. days, we got a bit of warmth there. Holy! That was freaking serious, eh? Ready, what's this? Holy. That's right to the mat. That's all she's got. Anyways, let's shut her down, I guess, and let's let her warm up a bit more. See if she'll get up to the 100 there. I'll keep an eye on it. If she gets up there, I'll flip the camera back on for you. Wow, now that kind of worries me. It's really low now. Holy, that is almost zero. Doesn't take up very much either when you juice her. But anyways, we got almost 100 there, so. Huh. I wonder if that pump is going in this thing or something. Stupid thing. I wonder if we're going to have to drop the oil pan off her maybe and tear the pump out of her and see if we can get another one to throw in it maybe. I don't know. That's not too good though. Maybe there's no oil in it. I don't know. Looks like we got our 100 though. Well, pretty much. Good heat there now. I wouldn't say it's really hot, but I wonder if the heater core's got a bit of a bung up in it like the truck did, maybe. Who knows? I think it'll be a while melting all that snow off, though. Holy. Oh, there we go. I think we got our 100 now. Pretty close. Close enough for me, anyway. But, yeah, that oil pressure's a bit bad. I don't know what it should be at, but it probably should be up to 3, maybe. 30 or whatever that is. Oh, now we're over 100. Oh, I'm just gonna overheat now. Oh! Oh, there, the thermostat just opened. And rush a coolant into the engine. There, I should be cycling around and closing again probably now. Oh, that'd ever drop a lot, eh? Ooh-wee. Back up now. Oh, well. Shut her down. Okay, let's do it. Kinder! Where's the Dewey? The Dewey. Oh, but the Dewey. Okay. Hey, hey! Oh, hard chocolate today. Oh, it's a rattly one. Oh, oh, we already got one of these. Remember that one the other day there with the pictures, I think that's different, but let's slap it together here. And that one there. And then remember we, is that the right way? I think that's the right way. So you see the normal picture there, and then you put the Dewey, let me straighten this out a bit. Put the Dewey there in front, and then you can see, come on, Dewey. Let's go out a bit. See, like a different sort of picture. It doesn't seem to be working too well. Hang on a sec. Let's just try to see if we can see it this way now. There we go. I don't know what that is, but there's this side too. And looks like a pond and some turtles and stuff. Some aminals. Here we go. That's pretty cool. So we'll put that up with the other one, I guess. And I guess that's it for today. So anyways, you guys have a good night and stuff. And don't forget to come check out the Minecraft server. I'll put the numbers and stuff, you know, in the video thing here. And we got her set up now for doing, like, creative builds and stuff like that. And you basically come in and you... you acquire a plot, free charge, no charge for the plots, and then she's got a bit going there. Basically, that's one plot there. Let me see if I can see that. Yeah, and you can build whatever you want on that inside of that plot where the green is. So it's pretty sweet. There's lots of cool builds coming on already, and you guys should, if you got Minecraft, should be a part of it. So we'd like to see you on the server, and it's a 50 slot server, and we still haven't seen her maxed out yet. We got to get her maxed out. Test out the capabilities of the server that we paid for. So, but anyways, you guys have a good night, and we'll see you tomorrow. Got an extra bonus for you today, Tubes. This was a Kinder, I think, from Holland. Somebody sent me a package of Kinders from Holland there, so we're going to open this one too. This one's a little bit older now, so it's kind of different stuff, I guess, but let's see here. What did we get? Oh, it's a race car. It's even the packaging is different with the do not swallow and stuff things. It's all attached to one, where the other one's like two separate little sheets. So anyways, it's like a little NASCAR or Indy car, I guess. So I'm guessing that goes in there. And this is its canopy thing. Goes on top. There we go. That's pretty cool. A little race car. Neat. But anyways, just another added bonus for you today. And I guess there's one, two, three others that you can collect. We got the green one. And there's a couple. It looks like a yellower, and a blue. So anyways, here we go. Anyways, have a good day again, Tubes. We'll see you tomorrow.